With the offices located along Mariana Street in Kasese Municipality, the Amnesty Commission DRT Kasese intends to profile all royal guards who are scattered within the five districts of Rwenzori region, including Kasese, Bunyangabu, Kabarole, Ntoroko and Bundibujo, so that they may tap into various privileges.
We started documenting the former Omusinga royal guards and profiling their details. We started with the district of Kasese. We continued with the Bunyangabu, Kabarole, Ntoroko, and Bundibujo. These people are very many in number and fragmented in very many areas, but we have done what we are supposed to do.
Edwin Mumbere, the coordinator of the former Obusinga wa Rwenzori Royal Guards, says joining Amnesty might help them get national identity cards, which they lost when the palace was stormed in 2016, adding that the lack of national IDs has made them fail to benefit from government programs. He also added that most of his colleagues still face the challenge of trauma, but also physical and psychological problems originating from the very day when the palace was stormed, as well as the 7 years spent in jail.
Another challenge we are having is the trauma. Many of our people are still having physical challenges on their bodies and their mind. Like, so far we have approximately 5 people who are having mental problems, and they are having that is psychological challenges. So I call upon the people who are having the counseling and some other approaches of how we can bring back the mind of our people.
However, His Majesty Charles Wesley Mumbere, the King of Obusinga wa Rwenzori, continues to extend his sincere gratitude to the government of Uganda for dropping all the charges imposed on him and his subjects, and pledges to work closely with the government in implementing its programs. The Amnesty Commission DRT Kasese office has for long granted amnesty services to returnees of different rebel groups. Ronald Sekatawa, the coordinator of amnesty programs, appealed to the rebels who are still causing havoc to communities to come and grab opportunities before they commit unforgivable atrocities.
We have those people now whom we cannot now say that we can offer them amnesty. For example, you can get an example of the recently captured commander called Njovu, probably last week he was aligned in court, and as we talk now, he has to answer charges of atrocities committed in the bush. This is where we say that amnesty formerly used to be blanket amnesty, but these days it's no longer blanket amnesty. Whoever who commits gross human rights offenses while in insurgence, he will no longer have an opportunity to benefit in amnesty.
On June 13, 2023, Jane Francis Abodo, the Director of Public Prosecution, dropped all charges imposed on Mumbere and his subjects, including treason, attempted murder, and aggravated robbery, giving them a chance to come in and hail in their various communities after several years in jail. Story by Samuel Amanyire for the news.